As some of you may just have heard in Italian, we have the Orchestra di Santa Cecilia here. They're going to play us some music and they're going to talk to us as well. So here we are, the Orchestra of Santa Cecilia.
So hello everybody. And we are the education staff of Accademia Nazionale di Santa Cecilia. And Accademia Nazionale di Santa Cecilia is one of the most ancient music institutions all over the world. It has been founded in the 16th century in Rome, and it's 500 years it brings music to people. But before we speak, I prefer we play. Let's hear a little music. And let me introduce my friend and colleague Gregorio, playing. Yes, please. Do you know what instrument is this?
French horn.
Not at all. Tuba, yeah, it's basso tuba. It's a tuba. It's a fascinating instrument. I don't want to speak. Please, Gregorio, play for us. I need somebody help. Okay, thank you. So, now we have introduced to you very different kinds of instruments. I guess for many of us, of you, a classical concert may be quite a new experience. Is it?
No.
Not at all? Okay, I'm very happy for this. So, if it isn't, we will speak in a more profound way. So, first of all, I would like Gregorio to explain to us how a brass instrument works, because it's very interesting.
Okay, this is a tuba. Okay, this is a brass instrument. Probably you know other brass instrument. Somebody had a mistake with this instrument. He called him a French horn. Okay, all brass instruments are French horn, trombone, trumpet. A trombone, you remember, is this one that you can probably see playing this way.
Okay.
All the similar characteristics of this instrument that are all made by brass, by a metal, a yellow metal, called brass. Okay, the function of this instrument are very simple. This is only a tube. This is not this instrument that make the sound. The only part in which we can make the sound is this one. All the rest of the instrument is only a tube that amplificate the sound that you form in this you create in this mouthpiece. Okay, the similar characteristic of all brass instruments are that they are a tube, they have a mouthpiece, they have some finger, some mechanism to make the tube longer and shorter. Okay, you must see that this position, this finger, this mechanism is not.
Don't forget them.
Okay. You see that we have also in the trumpet, you see three mechanisms. Why? Then I explain why. Okay, the sound in the tuba and in the all brass instrument is made in this one, just like this. Yes, you must imagine that all my life I make this one. All the brass instruments I make in his life make only booze buzzing in the mouthpiece. The sound of the mouthpiece is amplified by the tuba. This way, I show you. Just similar to the electronic device. Sometimes you have the device that produces the sound and another device that amplifies the sound. It's all electronic, but you have the master that you make by the computer or by other device, and then you have the amplification, that this is one. Is the difference from bass instrument and electronic instrument, but also between the other instruments that you see this afternoon with us, is they are only acoustic instrument. We have no electronic device that amplifies the sound. Okay, why we have only four fingers? Because you know that the notes that we can produce are a lot. You see, because this is not we have not the rapport from one note, one fingers, but a lot of notes with one position. I want to explain. If I don't push anything, I can make not only one note, but a lot of notes. Here. If I push one finger, I have the same series of notes, but just a half tone lower. You see, this is a first series, one finger, the tube became longer and longer, and you can make the series of notes, not only one note, lower, lower, lower. Mixing up one note from one series and mix another from that, you can have the scale, the all the grade of the scale. This is the reason because all the brass instrument, trumpet, trombone, have only seven position. Because mixing up one, but you can push two together, you have all the note. Okay, another characteristic of tuba is that is the lower of the bass instrument. So it's the instrument that makes the note more in the bass register of the scale. Okay, this is a tuba, is one of the young of the brass section, because it was created only in the last centuries. Why? Because trumpet, you can find a trumpet also in the medieval period. But this instrument was the younger because it was technically difficulties to make up a tuba, and then because the ancient instrument, they have not a very great sound, so they don't need in the low register a very big sound from a brass instrument. But from the last century, the sound, and then arrived to the electronic device, the sound of the orchestra, the sound of the music became bigger and bigger and bigger, until we found the electronic device that permit to have a big sound. But then it's not a breaking when it arrived, but from 8th century, music need more power. More power at the beginning, for this reason, born tuba. Also the contrabass, you see the contrabass, then my friends Storino explained, my friend Francesco explained about string. Also the contrabass became bigger because the hair needed more sound. The orchestra became larger. In the 18th century orchestra, we have 20 string. They became 30, 40, 50. At the end of the beginning of the 20th century, we have 100 and more and more and more. Mahler writes a symphony for 1,000 instrument. Okay.
It is usual. Is it usual that in an orchestra there are two or three tubas playing?
Okay, always the most 90% of the piece of the orchestra in which we can find the tuba, there is only one tuba. There is some piece, especially for Berlioz, especially for Strauss.
Mahler, too.
Mahler, not. I don't remember Mahler with two tuba. Strauss and Berlioz, we need two tuba.
Stravinsky,
no, two tuba.
Maybe it's Wagner.
Ah, so Rite of Spring, yes. Rite of Spring, you have a two tuba.
Rite of the Spring.
Yes. And there are reasons when we need to create the tension. Then we speak about the tension.
Because some 19th century composers actually added a lot of low instruments in their
yes.
works, and they needed a lot of instruments like a double basses and tubas maybe.
Yes.
Wagner.
Yes.
Wagner was
Schoenberg
heavy,
also.
Was almost like heavy
there
metal.
Are two reasons in which they employ bass instrument, not only bass brass, but also bass strings, because they needed two situations. The first was the what I said before, that they need more sound. When you need more sound, you need to improve mostly the bass and then also the head rhythm, because the hair of the men, the human people, you know that it's easier to hear the central range. You have difficult to hear the lower and also the very high lower. Our hair is able to distinguish very good in the middle of the range, when you're going up and down. So when you want to employ the sound, you need to employ more the lower. Probably, I don't know, in the old device, we find a push that we push in this way. You send immediately the sound that it becomes wider. It's only a little trick, an extra trick. Employ the bass and the low and the higher. Mm-hmm. So, and the second reason is to make the people afraid. Mm-hmm. it's very another trick. For example, Schoenberg or Stravinsky use two tuba, is a lot of contrabass to make a situation of afraid, of tension. Right. If you improve just like this.
Can the tuba produce harmonics?
Same pass.
Can the tuba produce harmonics?
Wait, the same pass, the player here. Don't make you afraid, but in the lower register. But it's poor, so they need one tuba, two tuba, two double bass to employ. Okay.
But can the tuba produce harmonics, those high tones inside the note?
Theoretically, you can go as high as you want. Practically, it was the ability of the player. We work only with harmonics. When I play,
I know.
These are the second, the third, and the fourth harmonic. Mm-hmm. The first harmonic of this tuba is this one. You can choose the second harmonic. Answer the first harmonic, the second harmonic. You can arrive higher and higher and higher.
But I guess I will answer to your question with the cello where I can go much higher,
yeah.
And I will show you.
Okay. The last thing in which I remember one piece, particularly, in which brass instruments are used to make afraid and to make a strange situation. It's a piece of Schoenberg. It's not very executed. It's called Gurrelieder. Gurrelieder is a piece of Schoenberg in which he wants to represent a lot of scene of this piece, of this country, Gurre. Okay. In this piece, in one point, he wants to represent the, what's it called, skeleton? School?
Skeleton.
Skeleton that at the end of the night, when they go down in the heart. Mm-hmm. And they use three tubas and two contrabass posaun, and just like a skull go down, 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 to represent is a situation. It's a passage just like this one. Okay, other question? Later.
The tuba was also... The tuba was also used a lot in popular music, like martial bands and jazz bands in the beginning, right?
Not solo, but one of the most famous composers for march band, the marching band. This is John Philip Sousa.
American.
Yes. Not only composed for tuba, but he built a tuba. Probably you see a tuba that is going just around the body of the player and going this way. This is just like similar to this one. It's only the shape that is changed, because it's only a tube that in which, instead of this shape, is a shape just around the body of the bringer and the player. He started this kind of tuba to make it easier to transport while he was playing. And also for an aesthetic reason, because the bell, it was not going up, but going in front. So he has two advantages. The first advantage is that the sound, when you play in the open air, don't go out, but go in the people, in the orchestra. The second reason is aesthetic. With the big bell, you can write the name of the band, the name of the composer, you can enjoy this one.
How long is the tube?
This tube is 4 meters, without pushing it. But the most popular tuba is a B-flat tuba, is 6 meters longer. Pushing the valves, you can go to 8 meters longer, just about.
Thank you.
Ciao. Ciao.
So now I can show you some secret about string instruments. Of course, I have a cello, and I speak about the cello, but what I will say is for all string instruments. So first of all, maybe interesting that in Italian, Italy is the where string instrument has been invented. Okay, in Italian, the name is not string instrument but bow instrument, strumenti ad arco, bow instrument. First of all, I will explain that the name of the bow can sound strange because the shape is not the shape of a bow, but this is now. When the string instruments were founded in the 14th century, the original shape of the bow was exactly a bow, was like this, was convex. Okay. Then with passing the time and needing more effects. First, for example, the springing bow effect, like this. Can you see that the bow springs on the string? They found that this kind of shape was much better to do this. And with the centuries, the shape changed in this way. Speaking about the bow, maybe quite interesting to see. Do you know what material is this one?
Horsehair,
okay, everybody knows, but the secret I want to explain to you. Do you think it's male or female or both? It does. It's male, only male. Why? Not at all. No. Very, very characteristic matter. You know, think about physiology. There's a problem. This is a horse tail, of course. Okay? Think about a horse, think about
substances that end up in a horse's tail, not with a male horse, but with a female horse?
For example. Okay, I speak without any problem. Think a horse when it pisses.
Exactly.
You know? Okay, a male will piss this way. A female will piss this way on his tail. So the problem is that the female horse hair stinks. This is the only
matter why we use male horse. That's just funny, but nobody knows. But it's the only matter. Otherwise, we can use all kind of horse, of white horse. White horse instead of black horse. This is a real difference, a physiological difference. Black horse gives hair for double bass bow, because it's thicker. We need thinner hair, so we use white horse hair. Okay. Then, when you look to a string instrument, you can see a body. That's the main part of the instrument. But what you can't see is what's inside the body of the instrument. Because it's not only empty. Inside there are two principal parts, two main parts. There are one piece of wood, a little cylinder of wood that connects the upper to the bottom, and its name in Italian is anima, that means soul, because its position is really the soul of the sound. It depends on the correct position of this little wooden part, how the sound will be good or better than not so good. And the other one, in English, it's soundpost. Soundpost. In Italian, it's sol. Okay, we are more poetic, I don't know. The other one is the chain. Name is chain, because it's a wooden piece running on the upper part of the body in this way. Both these pieces of wood for all string instruments have the responsibility to amplify the sound, to make the sound possible to transmit to all the body of the instrument, and then to be released from these holes named Fs, for it's evident why. The shape is only for aesthetical matters. And it push out the vibration of the string. The cello in the range of the string instrument is like a tenor in human voice. It has characteristics. It reaches all the range of the human voice, from the bass to the female voice, and then more, going up to many, many, many notes usually played by the violin for their height. It's very, 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 very large range of notes. For example, I can show you the harmonics you were asking. The harmonics you were asking. What do we mean when we speak about an harmonic? If we have a principal note, maybe this one. This is a theory coming from Pythagoras. Okay, so it's very important. If you cut the string in two equal parts, this sound will be an octave upper. Okay, and I show you immediately. If I put my finger at the exact half of the string, if the sound of the open string is this, with my finger in the middle, will be an octave upper. If you divide it into three parts, will be two octaves, an octave and a fifth upper. So this is a third of the string. Then two octaves. So the more you divide the string, the upper goes the sound. Okay, these are harmonics.
You see that when he make higher notes, he push here, okay? Face into the note, he want to do it. But for the property of the harmonic, it can push also very soft here. Fa sentire l'armonico quando preme qua su in alto. Mm-hmm. You see that he is pushing here, in this point. Okay. It's just like he make it here, 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 here. A division, cioè in pushing this point is a...
For example, if I just... push very lightly here, I divide the string in four parts.
Okay.
It's the same, three and one, so, but it's like I have divided the whole
you
string
see, or people
in four
see.
Parts.
If you push here, the sound becomes also higher, because it's just like if he divided in eight parts. So
and
so
on.
It's a push here, but it's just like a push here, 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 here. The exact point, the exact eight part of the chord.
I can use this to make the higher sound is possible. They are harmonics.
I want to show
he meant with harmonics.
Probably you don't know, but heard only with attention to this note. If you heard very very carefully, you see you heard after the one after fifth 10 seconds this note.
Look for it.
You are able to hear the higher note.
Can somebody hear this?
Are you able? It's very soft because inside the first note there are a lot of harmonic. The fifth is the harmonic that we heard better, but there are all the harmonic of the chord. Okay.
Yeah. Now I just want to play something because I want to show what a cello is in, for example, romantic music. A cello in romantic music is a singer. A singer without words. And in fact, I want to play a piece by Felix Mendelssohn named Lied ohne Worte. Lied ohne Worte. That's a song without words. Okay.
In the Baroque period,
in the
Baroque,
yes,
the Baroque period.
You love Baroque, yeah? Is it?
Yes, I heard a lot of Baroque through my life. Anyway, in the Baroque period, I remember that in the orchestras there were no double basses yet. Was the cello a big solo instrument for those pieces?
Maybe I have to explain you better what did no double basses mean, because it's not exact. It were no double basses simply because their name was not double bass. You have to know that double bass, that I find is one of the most fascinating instruments existing, is quite a new instrument, but its shape and its kind of technique depends very strictly on his grandfather, that's the violone of the Baroque music. For example, string instruments, modern string instruments, are the evolution of the viola family of the Renaissance period.
Viola di gamba.
Please let me, viola di gamba, for example, yeah. But double bass is quite the same that the viola da piede, that's viola da piede, that was the old name of double bass in Baroque and the Renaissance period. But it's not true, there was not bass instruments in Baroque music. There was simply violone instead of double bass. So it existed a bass instrument for Baroque music. Cello was not a great solo instrument in Baroque period, because cello was in a strange situation. I can explain in a very short time. But viola da gamba, the old parent of the cello, was a noble instrument. Noble not for a particular characteristic or something like this, but because it was played in the courts. So it was noble because it was played by kings, for example. It was considered noble. When they found an instrument like the cello, whose sound is much powerful and rich than the one of the gamba, of course there was a great reaction to this. And cello was considered en français, le pauvre diable, a poor
devil.
Yes, poor devil. And only with Johann Sebastian Bach, this idea started to change. And so this is why in Baroque music, only Vivaldi wrote some concerts for cello. Vivaldi and cellists, but not famous composers like Tartini, maybe, like Corelli, the great Baroque composer, Handel, Telemann. Nobody of them wrote a cello concerto. Nobody of them, because of this. Let me say that I consider viola da gamba a fantastic instrument, very fascinating instrument. It's a pity I haven't one now, but its sound is very soft, it's so beautiful. So the importance of the cello starts with Bach and with the classical period, Beethoven, for example. They are the first composers important composers for cello. Okay? Is it? Okay. But I want to change now.
Want to speak about tension?
Cosa?
Want to speak about tension? Vogliamo parlare della
tensione?
Yeah. Okay.
Before us, I heard the lecture that was before hour one, and it was very interesting because I heard about tensions. What was the idea of?
Because
the
many things. We play acoustic instrument. Usually, you use electronic device. Well, what is the matter that we need to make the same, we and you? We need to make up the attention of the person who heard us. We with our instrument and we and you with your instrument. Sometimes we also use electronic device. And what is the principal things that make up the person, the attention of the person? The attention is made up by the tension. How we can create the tension with music, with our instrument? We want to explain something about this, okay?
Okay, but before speaking, we have to play.
Yeah, we have a piece written by Francesco. The name of the piece is arancione, just like the color. And heard this piece not only, just like my shirt. Yes, try to hear this piece, not only think to the music that I think is a beautiful music, but why, in which are the point that they make the attention go up, and which in the point in which the attention and the tension go down.
Many of you have already heard this because we started with this piece, but now we will play again just to speak about this piece afterwards. This will be another thing we will speak about, the fine tuning of the instruments. We will speak about afterward.
We can change the tuning by, for example, he using the mechanism at the top. In the tuba, in all the brass instruments, probably you see trumpet player that move this valve.
Pump.
This pump is the principal pump. Moving this, you can put the pitch lower and higher of the total instrument. Okay. Aspetta, Francesco, riesco. Laura.
So, have you heard how we started in a mood and ended in another? And this is made just to create in various ways a tension. For example, what did we do? This. First of all, we made clear the difference of the increasing number of players. Of course, first I played alone, then with the tuba, and then we were three. But this is obvious. Less obvious is the use of the dynamics. How did we use dynamics in this piece? For example, when I started alone, I played quite soft, but not so soft. For example, the start was this. Don't worry, this is usual. Even and it's normal that this happens, but it's not so normal when it happens to the players. And it happens even in the concerts. There's some player during a concert looking for his personnel to switch off during a concert. It's very fun. But returning to our tension, dynamic tension. I wrote in this piece, the starting of the piece is piano, soft. But when the tuba starts to play, I wrote mezzo forte, not so soft. But if I play, I played not so soft the start, and softer when the tuba get in, please. Directly from your start. Okay. Yes, okay, this is your start, but I was wrong.
The entire bar.
number?
Is 21.
21. Okay.
Third movement.
All the bar, please.
Okay.
Okay. it's stronger, the sound, but it isn't. Simply, two instruments instead of one are playing, first. Second, the harmony is richer than the beginning. And this gives an idea of increasing something. But I didn't do it playing stronger, even because this piece is 3 minutes of music. If I start, if I play too loud now, how can I play at the end when I I need to break my instrument to play so loud? I can't. So I have to use, this gives tension. When a dynamic is used in a way you can't expect. Another example of this, maybe louder with you, play, let's play, please, bar 41, your beginning.
Andiamo fino al piano?
Sì.
Da quando entra Laura?
Esatto. Did you hear what happened?
Yeah.
Suddenly, the dynamic was down.
A real contrast.
Real contrast, yeah. But in the whole, you can't feel it as a piano moment, a soft moment of the music, but like something has happened, like a broken breath, you know. What happened? This gives more attention, even if we play it in a way that seems to be a distension way. Okay, is it clear? Did I explain myself?
Yeah.
This is one way. Another example is the rhythmical example. The beginning of the piece is this. Going on is this. Then, and more, more again, and finally, these are examples of diminution of the rhythm. Every time, faster, 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 and faster, but not faster in the movement, not faster in the beat, but faster in the writing. Like this. This is another way to give a rhythmical tension. And this is very important, because the faster you write, the bigger will be the impression of the music. It's quite strange, because usually we think that faster music sounds like a more tense music. This isn't true. For example, if I play the same piece at two speeds, hear this. This is like this. But if I play it faster, maybe you can see I have some difficulty to play, but the idea was, the first idea was like, was this. The second idea was this. It's slower.
It's in the middle.
Yeah, the the feeling is slower. The music is faster, but the feeling is slower. And this is a way to make a distension, not a tension. The tension is given playing at exactly the same tempo. For example, for you, this is very good because you have a very familiarity with the electronic devices. Electronic devices have a great advantage in keeping the tempo. When you use a loop, you are sure that you will have the same beat. And you decide if you want to change. It's not given by personality. It's not the same when you play with acoustic instruments. You risk, when you play an instrument like this, to rush or to slow down the music. And this is why using acoustic instruments, increasing rhythms gives tension, because you have to keep the control of the rhythm. You have absolutely to make up your mind to control what's happening on the rhythm. I feel a little envy for electronic device because of this, because they give you something sure, for example, with the rhythm. But my envy stops when I think that I can take the control of myself to have the same rhythm. And if I want, I don't do this. I give a little more. For example, I change a little the tempo. I did this. Maybe you didn't feel, but if you had an electronic device keeping the tempo, you have felt that I was a little pushing the tempo. It was a little faster than the start. I can do this. This is my advantage, our advantage with acoustical instruments on the electronic devices. Please.
Okay. Resuming what he was going to explain, Francesco, what is that make you be in attention about music, but not only music, also in your life, also in literature, also in the life? If you want to make tension, what is it that you make you afraid? Is what is unexpected? You are in tension, you are in afraid, also when you have something that you don't know, when you don't know what is going to happen, when you going to something that is you don't know. What is the opposite of tension? Is boring. What is boring? Is what you know.
Thank you.
Something repeat. How you can create the more music, or more literature, or
boring.
More book,
boring.
Or more life, more evening?
Boring.
When you repeat the same thing all the time, when the people expect what you are going to perform, what you are going to present, what you are going to speak. The people is intention is and give you his attention when he don't expect. And you can have the attention of people, and which probably is useful for your work, also in electronic music, also when you are in a disco or music, in a happening. How you have two way. The one is the progression. In the piece of Francesco, these are all two situations. The first way you can create tension is by progression. What means? To go in one direction. It can be in the sound.
Okay, so I think you use this rhythm very, very usual in your composition, because it is a modern rhythm. And the last one is the more complicated, so introduce another argument, that is the harmony. In this variation, Mozart changed the mode from major to minor. I don't know, I think you know major, minor, or you know chord.
We explain later.
Yes,
after
yes,
we explain it. With the help of Francesco.
And this melody is in, this variation is in a minor mode, and you can listen that the character is more intimate, is different from other variations, because minor mode has this function, this effect to create an intimate, a sad character. So if you want to create a sad and intimate melody, you can use minor mode, that is more efficient by the major. This is the variation. It's different. Okay, and finish, and you can tell about
harmony. The matter introduced Laura, introduces to another matter. You see, and you heard how Mozart changed the melody in rhythm, especially in the laughter when it's just like jazz rhythm. It's Mozart in jazz. It's Mozart, original Mozart. But the most important is the last one. You must know that the music of two centuries, our music of two centuries, from perhaps three centuries, from 17th century to the last century, from the 20th century, is based on two moods, major and minor. You know that one, you know about this. All the music, and also the music you use in an electronic device is based on these two moods. And this is one of the mystery of the music. The difference from major and minor. You must know that this is a music played in major moods. The same notes, we change only one note of a half tone. It means that from only change these notes, heard the music. You feel the moods from happy to sadness, major, minor. He changed only one note of half tone. Nobody knows why changing these notes we feel sad moods instead of happy moods. And this is only not only in our civilities. Also, if we make heard this music in a tribal people or in another country, in Japan, in Brazil, in Cape Town, and so on, people have perceived that is a happy moods and a sad moods. Nobody knows why. And on these two, on these two moods, it's based the music from the 17th century,
no,
after
16th century,
to the last century. Then, in the, after the beginning on the 20th century, something changed. They discovered other way, other, but these two moods remain still today in the, all the light music, the principal moods in which is composed the notes. And nobody why. And this is another thing that is collegated to the what to the tension. If you want people to make tension, you must don't play this note. This note. What I mean? This the note that we change from the half tone is the note that you make you happy or sad. Okay. May I heard? Happy and sad. If you put away this note, fa sore, sore. We don't know how your mood is. And this is a trick, another trick to make tension. A trick used, for example, from Henry Mancini. You know who is Henry Mancini? He's a composer that composed the soundtrack of...
Yes,
of Pink Panther, yes. You remember the beginning of Pink Panther?
Breakfast at Tiffany's.
But especially in the Pink Panther, you remember how the Pink Panther begin? Yes, but before this, I see. What make Henry Mancini in these three notes? Dun, dun, dun. He needs to make you in tension. He needs, Nari Mancini knows that this yellow, a film, you know, the film is a story of diamonds that was keeping. So you need a music to make tension. So the first things that Harry Mancini did is put away the modal note, the note that make you happy or sad. So when you heard, make it, follow. Okay. Now you don't know is happy or sad. Have the same music with the modal note. For example, happy. This is sad. Okay. It's not. You are not afraid. You are, you know that is happy or sad. Putting away this note in all the music, you have. You are not. You don't know what happened. This is a way to make tension. So you must know that the note that make the mood happy or sad, major or minor, is very important also for this region. Okay.
In the Pink Panther theme, we know it's minor only when the theme is already started.
In this point,
only now. So this is cute because we have to wait for 1 minute music to know this. This is the tension.
This was the trick of our
for 1 minute. We don't know. It will be major, minor, modal. We don't know.
And a lot of composers in classical music, also in the soundtrack music, use this way to make you senza accorgere without.
But the first to do this was Ludwig van Beethoven in the Ninth Symphony. The Ninth Symphony of Beethoven starts like this. For 1 minute we have two notes, D and A. And those notes don't tell to us what's happening. We only know there's this. Minor!
Okay.
But it took 2 minutes to know it, okay? So we are thrilled like this. Wait, what's happening? I don't know.
And this situation makes that we have in the scale, a hierarchic position of the note. So when we decide in the most of the music that we use every day that you use, we have a hierarchic position of a note. There is a bass note, the fundamental, for example. Then there is a dominant, the second for important for something. Then there are another position, for example, there is the sensibile, there is the note that you can never stop on this note, for example, see? You can stop there, you sent it, di farlo ancora? Falla! No! Esatto.
It's the leading note, but it's sometimes.
Yes, it's the leading note sometimes. And this is the modal theory. You must understand that in the last century, they You're put right. away all this, okay, understand. They put away all this hierarchic way, and they study another way to make music. And then we have time, and we'll explain what's about that.
The microphone.
What's your name?
Alex.
Yeah. From Brazil.
Well, we were talking about tonality, music, which is a concept that was mainly explored after the Baroque period. Bach had a great work with the well-tempered clavier.
Yes.
That established it. It was, in my opinion, it was a scientific essay about tonality, which is actually, also once again, in my opinion, a gravitational force in between notes. But what about modal music?
Yes,
that's very interesting. First of all, I absolutely agree with your opinion. The tonality is a gravitational system, but it works even with modality. The tension in this sense in modality lays on the mode itself,
uh-huh.
but the mode may be considered as a son of the tonality, you know.
Or a father, who knows.
Sorry?
Or the father, because the note, the concept of mode is earlier.
Yes.
Scientifically.
Yes, it,
musical
sure,
science.
But you have to think about that with the 16th century, with Claudio Monteverdi, for example, was of common opinion that the winning theory was the tonal theory. And for four centuries, this was, and absolutely this. And only after Mahler, it changed.
Yeah.
Also, major and minor are modal music.
The Catholic Church had a great deal about establishing the modes that people could play.
Yes.
In the Middle Age.
Very long discuss this one. Maybe interesting, but
it's a little deep.
Yeah.
Yes.
But maybe now it's a little late, so I don't know. What time is it?
6 o'clock.
6 o'clock, non sei, right?
Volevo soltanto accennare alla serialità.
Ok, maybe we speak about this in another moment because it's very long, but very interesting. Now we have spoken about tonal music since now. We now want to change, and Gregorio can introduce another.
You speak about modal music, but what happened in the last century? After 3 centuries of modal music, major and minor. Just like in the visive art, in the pictoric art, they want to find other way to represent the reality, the civilization is going broken. Also, the music find a new way to represent. What they do is, this is a scientific way to make music.
Even.
They decide that all the notes of the scale are the same hierarchic situation. There is not the dominant, there is not the modal, there is not an attraction for note, but all the notes, you understand me, are the same important. This is a scientific, an academic, it was a decision. And they must found another way to build the music, because without rules, regularly, without rules, we can do nothing. So they decided on a table the new rules. One of the new rules that they decided was the serial music. You never heard about serial music?
Okay.
Alex,
we speak for you.
Okay, the serial music is a music in which you must make a serial. What is a serial? Is the all the 12 tone of the scale, and you must play all the 12 tone of the scale before to play another time one of the all the 12 notes. I don't, you understand what that means? You must play. You have a 12 tone in a scale. The first scala scale sottotonata. You have it. Okay, you have this serial, you have this 12 note. You can choose the sequence. You can first one, then another, then another, then another, and then you have 12 notes. But you can't play the same notes 2 times. When you have the complete series, you can make another one. You can make, and this is the academic way to make it. You can make the same series in the inverse. You can play in the opposite direction. You understand me? You have the serial, then I play one of these. Then you can play the same in the opposite direction. Then you can change the interval. If you make it just like in a mirror. This is an academic way that it takes about...
A mirror reverse.
Yes, it's about 50 years in the last century. It began with Schoenberg. With Schoenberg and go on. I play, for example, an example of a serial music written for tuba in... 1990. It's for tuba. You understand? I play the first 12 notes are all different. Then I play the same note in the opposite direction, but change the tune. This is what happened. Okay, sorry. If you see the music, and then you see that this is okay. This is the first area. The second staff is exactly identical of the first, just read in the opposite. This is the way. Then the piece go on. And this is it. What means this? That they want to find a new way. When you heard this music, probably it don't sound strange in your hair. But you must understand that at the beginning, about 1920, it sounded very strange. It was just like a scandal, when they make this music. But they go on. The other situation that we can find two different way to make music is using the sound of the nature. Probably this is the way that you can do with the electronic device and you can improve with electronic device. Using, for example, cascade sounds, river sounds, martello, come si dice?
Hammer
sounds, and music using the sound of nature. And you can make music just using this way, using the train sound and so on. And sometimes they have a mix using a tape, using an instrument that represent sounds of the nature, some of the civilization.
Okay. Maybe we have talked so much, it's enough. And I love to end with music.
Yeah.
Okay. And okay, we're thinking about to play something by Chick Corea. Okay. Yeah. Because we do believe, and this is the matter for which we are here, that differences between classical music rather than jazz, rather than all kind of music, is not a difference that makes a contrast. It's only a difference to inform us that the music is different by another. But the great music is only great music. Leonard Bernstein said there are only two kinds of music, good music and bad music. I agree at all. So, when I am here, I learn so much from what you are doing, because it's very, very interesting and very important, because the history of music is going on, and you are not only the present, but also the future of music. We are too, and we love to have this kind of experience, common experience in music. So now, we can do this with Chick Corea, and why not? I hope we can do something together sometimes. I really hope. Okay, please. Would you like to improvise something with us? Yeah. Something once?
Yes.
Okay. Who wants? Come here.
Grande Alex.
Thank you to everybody.
Domanda se ci sono altre domande.
Of course, if there are some questions. We will try to answer.
If there are some more questions, we are here to answer. Not only for Alex. Eh? No, okay. Oh.
Please.
What do you think is the most important thing about when you're arranging your composition?
What another?
Sorry.
The thing to remember when arranging your composition?
When we arrange. So.
Go ahead. You have the maximum expert. Dipende a che destinata, se per I bambini.
There are many things that on which will depend this answer. It depends, for example, on first of all, on the personal feeling. So, what's important to me for I want to put yes, of the music. And first of all, myself. Okay, myself, not in an ego way, but in a feeling. What's my feeling about this music? What I want, for example, what happened now? If I had arranged this piece, my feeling is very rhythmical. Even the is a children's song, so a very nice theme, a very simple harmony. I feel a great impulse, rhythmic impulse inside. If I made an arrangement, for example, for this group, I would have written a very important rhythmical part. Something like a bodhran in Irish music, for example, I don't know. But another very important thing is to know absolutely perfectly the instruments you are going to use. The sounds, and not only the sounds, in our, especially in our field, the technique of these instruments is fundamental. Because if you want a sound, if I want a tuba sound, for example, I must know that this instrument can do this. I think it's the same in your field. You have to know perfectly you have to know perfectly this, because otherwise you will bring only an idea, your idea, but it will not pass, because the people who is playing this, or the instrument who is playing this, will not give this idea. I have a big deal with myself now, because I have just written a piece that I'm afraid it will be not possible to play. Exactly for this, because I wanted to push the technique of an instrument, in actually the cello, in such a way that I am afraid it will be not possible to play. But it's a deal with myself.
But why is that?
Because of technical matters. Because that's not my chair. That's very dangerous. I was sitting down on the nothing. I'm afraid I've written something I will not able to play.
But why do you use two people?
When I use two people?
If you can't play it, why don't you use two people to play it?
Because I have only one. I haven't another one.
But you get two people to put their hands on
it. No, this is not possible. Because it's quite complicated to explain. It's obviously not two people on one instrument. Okay. But two people playing the same part, there's a problem bent to the meaning, to the technical meaning of this part, both of them will not play this. So the deal with myself is I want to do this, because I like very much what I written, but I actually don't know if I will be able to do. That's a risk I can take on myself, not on another person.
But what is the risk that you actually, what is the risk you are making?
The risk? The great risk is that the music will be not my music.
No, but you cannot get the scale. You
No, I haven't finger enough to play, because maybe it's so difficult music. An example. I have an octave here. If I have to go more than an octave, it's very large, and it arrives a moment where my hands is too small to do all what I want to do. If I write this, I will not play, because my hand could not play this.
But that's why I ask you, why doesn't two people play the same instrument?
Because the coordination is absolutely impossible between hands. You know, there's a very interesting thing. technically speaking.
Sorry to cut you in there.
Is it too late?
Oh, no, I mean, you can continue it after we finish, but we need to wrap it up because we've got quite a tight schedule this evening. So once again, thank you very much indeed.
Okay, thanks to you.